Our surroundings constantly impress us with new miracles. Nothing happens by accident in nature. Evolution ensures that only the strongest survive. The researchers at HYBER Center of Excellence examine molecular-level pathways used by nature to achieve optimum material. Our learning from nature's teaching leads to new systems and functions that can be integrated for the benefit of society. The use of non-degradable plastics has ultimately led to ecological catastrophes, such as the Great Pacific Garbage Patch, which is twice the size of the United States. The world population is growing exponentially, while on the other hand, the natural resources are decreasing. Therefore, sustainable material development at low cost and minimum environmental impact will be the only way to warrant human well-being.
Nature has all kinds of interesting materials, like this mollusk knicker. It's lightweight, it's very colorful, its mechanical properties are very extraordinary, but it is very expensive. So you can't make airplanes out of this. But what about if in the future we could be able to make materials which are similar but cheap, and we could really make large-scale products and even airplanes out of this?
Civilization ages have been named based upon the raw materials used, the stone, the iron, and the bronze ages. We are living in the plastic age. HYBER is setting the standard for creating a new age, the bio age. Biological production means more sustainable materials for the benefit of more people. Microbes can consume waste or can grow biopolymers for clothing, etc.
So sometimes people worry that biological materials are not as good as synthetic materials. However, if you look at, for example, cellulose, it's on the micro level, it's stronger than what steel is. So the question is that how can we use biological methods to take the components of cellulose and put them together in a new way to produce materials that actually are better than synthetically produced ones?
Engineering technologies are developing at breakneck speed. What previously involved complex and slow-paced research can now be developed in a week. Computers that previously took up a whole room now fit in your pocket. Nanotechnology and genetic engineering have become a part of everyday life. Cells can be trained to produce new materials in cycles. With new technologies, nature's miracles can be mimicked. Moreover, materials can be synthesized biologically. With the research of HYBER and the wisdom of nature, we may witness bioproduced materials that are both cheaper and more durable than fossil-based ones.